Hi, my name is Silver Laidlow, and today I want to tell you a story. Are they my wank tissues? Shit, my lube's there too. Yeah, let's try this one again. Hi guys, my name's Silver Laidlow, and I am here today to tell you a story. A story of what, you may ask? Well, it's actually a story of the day that I met WWE superstar Neville. Started off like any other day. Woke up and I texted my girlfriend. Wait, no, I didn't. I caught her cheating on Friday with another guy. She said she wanted to meet him in a hotel room, and she was really, really looking forward to having sex with him, and I kind of Anyway, moving on swiftly, I thought, well, now I'm single, I can do what the fuck I want. I don't have to worry about this bitch lying next to me in the bed. I don't have to worry about none of this shit. So today, I'm gonna do something completely random. I'm not even that much of a WWE fan, but I heard he was in town, so I thought, fuck it, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna get a signature. Why the fuck not? What the fuck? Why the fuck? Why the fuck not? So me, Dap, and Faye made our way to HMV. To go and see Neville. We realised once we got there and we got our wristbands. Pretty cool, hey? Fuck, we ain't got nothing for him to sign. So we needed to go and get something for him to sign. So we went and got something for him to sign.
So I was thinking on the way up, I was like, what if I got
these? Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Really, though?
Oh. Cute
though. Fucking unicorns. Made up bullshit.
I got a bit hungry. Needed a Greggs. So I went for a Greggs.
Steak bake Cornish pasty apple juice.
Steak bake Cornish pasty apple juice, please, my love. 35 pence bags. That'll be the bane of me, them.
See, you know, when I was a young'un, we used to chip in £2.50 each for a bag every day.
I was just trying to eat my Greggs in peace. I was just trying to have a nice time with my Greggs. But my friends are not normal. Two questions no man ever wants to be asked by his woman. Why have you been watching porn?
Why have you been watching porn?
Sorry?
Why have you been watching porn?
When were you masturbating?
When were you masturbating?
Let's find out how he handles the situation.
Why have you been watching porn?
Sorry?
Why have you been watching porn?
Why? Houses come quicker when I masturbate.
When were you masturbating?
Just before I came.
Bruh. WWE shop. How unreal is this? Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair.
Ric Flair, nigga. Woo!
That's rare, nigga. Woo! Ric Flair, nigga. Woo! The power's in my hair, nigga. Woo! I get to beat the chair, nigga. Soho, a Tribeca. Three hoes, trifecta. Dope money.
Oh, hey, man. He's trying to dress up like me.
My wife's better, my brain's better. You go right.
Who the fuck is Mark Dindrake?
You don't want me to hold it on for too long, you know?
Now I'm in a queue to go and see a man who stands in a ring in his underpants and hits other men.
Ha! Gay!
Sometimes.
Just every day. Yeah? Just happens every day. No, no, it actually is Bray Wyatt. Definitely Bray Wyatt.
The buzzers, eh?
This guy's not a wrestler, he's definitely in character.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
So this girl here loves Chris Benoit.
Chris Benoit all the way.
If you don't know who Chris Benoit is, the guy that hacked his family to death and then killed himself.
They found the wrestler hanging by a pulley. And they also found Bibles placed beside the bodies of his wife and his 7-year-old son.
That's what I'm stood next to in the queue. If he was still alive and he came to your house, would you let him babysit your kids?
Yeah, I'd let him babysit me.
And if he got a bit violent, would you enjoy it? Would you like the rough and tumble? It's like the crack, is it?
Hell yeah.
All right. All right. All right. Killed his whole family.
Yeah.
His kids, wife, himself. And she loves him. Right.
So now we've got to near the front of the queue, right? I was chilling with the security guard.
Like, go, go, no, gadget.
No, I'll take no, that. No, I'll take that.
I think he looks like a nun.
I don't mean
do it. Inspector
Gadget. Don't be the furious.
She was 15.
He's up now. Talking about it. Inspector Gadget's daughter.
Oh my days.
Yeah, but you look 11.
Oh, God. I'm done. I'm dead.
You dead? Yeah, man.
I hope John Cena makes an appearance.
John Cena!
Better zip it.
Zip it. Debatable celebrity,
I'm
debatable.
I met Inspector Deck. I met Ferris.
Inspector Deck.
I met loads of Wu-Tang members. I met,
And that was the moment I realised he was about to try and sell me his mixtape. If it wasn't his mixtape, he was going to try and sell me his friend's mixtape.
I don't know, like, check him out, it's called Dr. G.
Another one.
Doctor?
Dr. G.
Another one.
Dr. G. A producer for loads of American artists.
He's a music producer, produced a lot of beats for like hip-hop artists in America and stuff like that.
Another one.
He even used to work for Sony.
He worked for Sony and promote a lot of albums.
I don't want your fucking mixtape.
Ooh, this is exciting, isn't it? To the front of the queue, thinking we were at the front of the queue, but no, it's just another queue.
I'm so excited.
Woohoo! You're gonna meet your favourite wrestler.
Yeah.
How did you feel when you met yours?
This is fire!
I was overwhelmed. It was like it never actually happened.
See your belt? Yeah! And I never actually realised how much fun you can have in a shop, you know, like HMV while you're queuing for things, if there's a ginger kid in front of you with a massive afro. Holding back me, you make me feel like this. So if you're out there, I'll the that I want. Knock, knock, knocking on. Welcome to the section where I'm never going to buy anything. It's Chocolate Daddy. And the three moustaches. Look at him. He looks like Uncle Phil from The Fresh Prince. We made it, funny unexpected anyone's gadgets. Let's get a little bit comfortable with the little boy behind them, you know what I'm saying? A little bit comfortable, you know what I'm saying?
I just look at these people like normal people.
Get Fanny Flutter. Jerry Kodo. Bro, you don't want to look under there, bro. You don't want to look under there. Oh my days. Bro.
This guy's trying to look like the Weeknd over here. Yeah.
You guys go ahead. I'm gonna stay here with my nigga. Go ahead.
I don't want your fucking mixtape.
So now was the time. I've waited for all day. Wait, hold on. It's not intense enough. Intense music. And now, it was the moment I'd been waiting for all day. I was going to meet Neville, the WWE superstar. So, what would I say? What would I do? What do I get him to sign? This is what I said.
Just the top one, it's for my little brother, Matt.
For your brother?
Yeah.
Right.
They told me I can only have one, so.
I'm gonna do two.
You can do that for us. Give us this one.
I'm a bit of a bad boy. Silver, that's an awesome one.
Silver. It's all right.
It's a silver.
Thank you very much, bro.
How red, come back on. Silver, look at my. How red.
In the words of Ice Cube, today was a good day.